Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Kankana's Health Forum, and in this video I'm going to discuss about a very important topic today, and that is teacher's instructions for a patient with permanent pacemaker. But before starting the video, if you are new to my channel, then kindly subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video you will get notified. Now let's start the video. So first of all, we have to know what is pacemaker. Pacemaker is an electronic device which is implanted surgically in patient's body to help patient's electrical system if it is failing. Pacemaker is usually placed at the left side of the chest just below the collarbone. Having a permanent pacemaker means you have to be very aware of do things a little differently when you get home. Here I am going to discuss 10 points how we can care our pacemaker after getting discharged from the hospital. So your first point will be maintain follow-up care with your primary care provider. Why? To check the pacemaker site and begin regular pacemaker function checks. Now we are coming to the number 2 point, that is, after getting discharged from the hospital, if you see that there is a sign of infections, like if there is a redness or if there is a swelling or if there is a drainage in the incision site, then you need to inform to your healthcare provider. You need to report them. Now the third point that you have to remember is that keep incision site dry for 4 days after implantation. And a fourth point you have to remember is that avoid lifting your arm on pacemaker side above shoulder until approved by your primary care provider. Now we are coming to the fifth point, that is avoid direct blows to pacemaker side. Why? Because it might affect the functioning of the pacemaker. Now we are coming to the sixth point, and that is avoid close proximity to high output electric generator or large magnets such as MRI scanner. Here the meaning is that whenever you go for a diagnostic investigation, you should avoid MRI because it might interfere with your pacemaker functioning. Now we are coming to the seventh point, that is you can use microwave oven because it do not interfere with the functioning of the pacemaker, so you can use that. Now let's come to the number 8 point, that is travel. Travel without restrictions is allowed. Whenever you are traveling to another country or other place through flight, then you should always inform to the security in the airport that you have permanent pacemaker. Now let's come to the number 9 point, that is monitor pulse. You have to always monitor your pulse, and you should inform to your healthcare provider or your primary care provider if it drops below the predetermined rate. Coming to the last point, that is number 10, and which is very important point, and that is carry pacemaker information card at all times, and a medic alert ID should be worn at all times so that if there is any complication occur, people will know about your health condition and they will help you quickly to get the hospital. So these are some 10 points that you have to remember after getting discharged from the hospital, how you have to take care of your pacemaker. So I hope this video is helpful for you, and these videos I am making for you to get some idea about the health issues and in a simple and a very short way, so that you will get understand about the topic and what is the main concept of the topic. And if you really like my videos, then kindly like, share and subscribe. And if you want to suggest me any topic related to health, then let me know in the comment section below. Till then, thank you so much.